लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट बुल्लस पेंपी गाइड. लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट बुल्लस पेंपी गाइड. लेट अस सी व्हाट इज दिस बुल्लस पेंपी गाइड. सी हियर, सब एपिडर्मल ब्लिस्टर्स आर फॉर्मड. सब एपिडर्मल ब्लिस्टर्स आर फॉर्मड. Let us see how these subepidermal blisters are formed. Before going to the mechanism, one thing we have to remember is it is autoimmune disorder. Autoimmune disorder. Okay, now moving to the mechanism how blisters are formed in Bullous pemphigus. See, basically in the skin we have two layers, right? Epidermis and dermis. Okay, this is epidermis, this is dermis, right? This is dermis. So the innermost layer of epidermis, the innermost layer of epidermis is called stratum basale. This is stratum basale. This is basement membrane, right? This is basement membrane and this is stratum basale. This is basement membrane on which we have cells, right? Stratum basale cells. These cells, they are connected to this basement membrane through hemidesmosomes. With the help of hemidesmosomes. Okay, these hemidesmosomes, they connect the cells of stratum basale to basement membrane. Okay, these hemidesmosomes, it contain two important proteins. They are Bullous pemphigus antigen 1 and Bullous pemphigus antigen 2. Okay, these are antigens. These are part of hemidesmosomes. Okay, these hemidesmosomes, they connect cells of stratum basale to basement membrane. Now in this disease, Bullous pemphigoid, what happens is autoantibodies are formed against this BPA1 and BPA2. Okay, autoantibodies are formed against Bullous pemphigoid antigen 1 and Bullous pemphigoid antigen 2. So when antibodies are formed against these proteins, are formed against these antigens will get destroyed, right? That means the connection of stratum basale to basement membrane will be lost. That means stratum basale cells will separate from basement membrane. Okay, this separation results in bullae formation or blister formation. Okay, blister formation. This is mechanism how blisters are formed in Bullous pemphigoid. As I told you, it is a autoimmune disorder and it is an example of type 2 hypersensitivity reaction. Type 2 hypersensitivity reaction. And this disorder, it is associated with pruritus. That means itching will also be there. And perilesional erythema will also be there. Means, suppose it is blister, around blister we will have erythema. We'll have erythema around this. Okay. That means perilesional erythema will be there. And in this disease, even melanocytes will also get involved. Melanocytes will also be involved. Due to involvement of melanocytes, it results in formation of small cysts of melanin. Small cysts of melanin. Okay, these small cysts of melanin. This lesion is called melia. It is called melia. These cysts of melanin is called melia. Okay, the onset of the age of onset is 60 to 80 years. 60 to 80 year, 80 years. You see, the blisters are formed subepidermally because they are found between basement membrane and stratum basale, right? So we can say in epidermis they are formed deep inside epidermis. Okay, they are formed deep inside epidermis, right? So as they are deep inside, they are tense bullae. Tense. We have to know what bullae is. Bullae is also a type of blister. Okay, basically blisters are of two types. Based on size, we classify these blisters into bullae and vesicles. In vesicles, the size is less than 0.5 centimeters, whereas in bullae, the size is greater than 0.5 centimeters. Okay, so bullae is nothing but a type of blister. Remember that. So the bullae are tense bullae. Okay, and one more important thing that we have to remember is bullae spread sign is positive. Bullae spread sign is positive. Let us see what is the bullae spread sign. So this is bullae, right, or blister. When we apply pressure either tangentially or perpendicularly, what happens is this bullae will move forward like this. Will move forward. This is called bullae spread sign, and this bullae spread sign is positive in bullous pemphigoid. Okay, and then move into investigations. So investigations, if you do histology, then subepidermal splits will be seen on histology. What we see is subepidermal splits will be seen. Okay, this is, and there also collection of eosinophils in this split. Okay, there is also collection of eosinophils. This is about investigation, and then moving to treatment. As it is autoimmune disorder, the drugs that we use mainly are steroids. As all of us know, steroids has got anti-inflammatory effect, right? So they also suppress immunity. So steroids are used, and tetracyclines are also used. In tetracycline, the property of anti-inflammatory effect is used. Okay, in the tetracyclines, they are mainly used for their anti-inflammatory effect, not for their antibiotic effect. Anti-inflammatory effect. Okay, and the last drug is dapsone. Okay, these are three important drugs that are used: steroids, tetracyclines, and dapsone. Okay, this is something about bullous pemphigoid. Thank you for watching.